I'm Larry Rice, encouraging you to join me as we move out of all the things that can depress us, distress us, cause us to feel hopeless, make us angry, frustrated, all of that, and somehow be able to move out of that. And let's develop a list of some of the things we have to be thankful for life, health, for a place to sleep, for opportunities to get involved and make a difference in the world in which we live in, opportunities to help the fatherless, the widowed, the hurting, the homeless. That's what we're doing here at the New Life Evangelistic Center, giving you those opportunities right now, helping you to develop an attitude of gratitude for a place that you have to sleep, and to begin to get beyond yourself and think about others that are in need. JD had to do that. She lost her grandfather. Her grandmother had custody of her. Her grandmother's name was not on the loan. She didn't know that because the bank had sold the loan and some other group had got it and left her name off. They ended up out of their home. She found herself sleeping in a van with her grandmother and her brothers. And then because of those of you that have been praying and sharing with the New Life Evangelistic Center, we were able to offer her a place to come. And she's thankful in the middle of all of this. And you have made it possible by letting God's light and love flow through you and supporting the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. I want you to discover that it is more joyful to give than to receive. And when you don't have it and you have to ask for help, it's a lot harder than freely giving. You got it. Give, care, share. We give you that opportunity here at New Life Evangelistic Center. The number is 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. I want to encourage you, to get involved right now and care and share. You can give online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. You can also just write out that check and send in that very special gift at this moment to P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, at 63166. The need is so great at this moment. But greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. I want you to hear the testimony from this young lady.
Hi, I'm JD, and the reason I believe in the Lord is because of the day after my 10th birthday when I was in fourth grade, my grandpa died. And it took a really long time for me to believe it, because I believed in the Lord before that, but then once he died, I felt like there wasn't a Lord I feel like he took my grandpa away for no reason at all. So I was mad. And then my grandma and my mom started talking to me, and I realized that my grandpa died for a reason, and that there really was a God, and that he wasn't evil. And also, when I became homeless, I was all sad and disappointed, and then I made a whole bunch of friends, like my friend Ranisha and her sister Ranina and her other two little sisters, and they've been really helpful and nice. And if I didn't have them as friends, I wouldn't know what to do, because they've helped me when I've been feeling sad, and I've helped them, and we've become really good friends. And if when they left, I was sad, but then they came back and I'm happy again. Okay. And also, I have been able to make my friend, a friend named Keisha, and she went to the Agape House, but we've been, we met each other at parks sometimes, and we've been hanging out, and I think that the Lord has sent me them to make me feel better and help me through these hard times.
Imagine if you were that young lady moving into a shelter like this. Joining me is a man that's often behind the camera. Steve's out here with me at this particular time, and Steve, how has it made a difference in your life because New Life was there?
Well, it makes, I found out what's important in life, and it's not a bunch of stuff. It's God and His good people.
It's God and His grace, right?
Yes, indeed.
You lost everything. Yes. Found yourself homeless. You're from Belleville, okay?
Right.
You came to New Life Evangelistic Center. How important was it to you that this place was open and giving you the opportunities you're getting?
Oh, it was just of utmost importance. There was nothing else. I had nowhere else to go. And, it's just been a blessing.
And
for
it's
sure.
been a blessing because of all of you that are a blessing right now. All of you that are going to these phones that are behind us over here at 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. And every dollar you share provides $3 worth of direct help because of our dedicated team of volunteers like Ola and many others, right?
Oh, absolutely. Yes. We couldn't do it without the folks out there helping us. You're right.
And you volunteers are very, very important at this time. Let's go to Ola.
My name's Ola Martin. I live in Wentzville, Missouri. I have to say that since I've been working with New Life Evangelistic Center, I have seen more miracles come to pass. I've seen things happen that through prayer that probably would not have happened otherwise. I've seen miracles pay for bills and things like that down here. We do love our supporters, our 24 Club 24 members. We need more people to join Club 24. It's just $24 a month, and you would be amazed at the difference it makes in the lives of people who have very little or nothing. People come in here with nowhere to stay, no clothes, no home, nowhere to sleep at night. And a lot of these people are women with little babies, and there are pregnant women. And so it you can't say that all the people down here are male winos or anything, because in order to see the extent, you actually need to come here. You need to come and visit. And someone would be happy to show you around, and you could actually meet some of the people. I've gotten acquainted with so many people down here, wonderful people, who just need a hand. Some of these people, I talked with them for several hours before I even realized that they had been homeless and that they were living here. I thought they were just volunteers like I was. And that's been an amazing thing to realize, that homeless people most of the time look just like everybody else, especially if they have a place to have showers and clean up, and they have some clothes to wear that look nice. And that's what we do for people down here. We clothe the people who need clothing. And a lot of people come in here who are not homeless as well, for clothing, for food, for assistance with their gas and electric bills. This is not just a homeless center. This is a center for blessing people with very little. And that's what we do here. We just hand out blessings. And the Lord has been with this organization, this ministry, for over 40 years. And countless, countless people have been helped here. People have walked in here with nothing, and they've gotten into training programs, and they were able to go out and get good jobs and be productive members of society. But just look into your heart and pray, and let the Lord place on your heart what you can give to this ministry, because you will be blessed in abundance. I know I have. Thank you.
Joining me is Dulcie, and she's our volunteer coordinator, and those of you who volunteer here know her. Volunteers are really important to us, aren't they, Dulcie?
Oh, yes, they're vital to everything that we do here, and helping the people that come in to the shelter, to having events and raising money to be able to continue to shelter people and to feed people, to provide all the assistance that we do with prescriptions and mm-hmm. bus fare. And
we're telling people, if they want to help us on Thanksgiving Day, they need to come on Sunday either at 2, or they can come on Wednesdays at 2 o'clock.
Yes, we have volunteer meetings at either mm-hmm. time that you can come and register. And as we gear up for Thanksgiving, mm-hmm. we also need volunteers to
go to the homes of people. We need drivers that will go to people's homes that don't have any heat on their home, don't we?
Yes, we do. We need those volunteers, and we also will need food and mm-hmm. other assistance. assistance for the dinner itself that day.
And just having, if people, they say they want to donate something, they want somebody to pick it up, we don't have drivers to go pick it up. We need that. And we thank God for people that are calling. The number's 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. Those that are calling right now are blessing, aren't they?
Yes, they are. It's very much a blessing to be involved and to work with the volunteers as well as the people that come in for shelter.
And we want to encourage you to call in. If you'd like to volunteer, you want more information, or maybe you'd like to at this time want to make a special donation, the number is 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. So note that and hear this. Again, it's 436-2424.
Hello?
1-800-334-3276. And we do need people to go to the phones right now, don't we, Dulcie?
Yes, we do. Please call in and we can give you more information about Thanksgiving Day and all the needs that we have that day to serve the dinner. We usually serve 300 to 400 people on that one day in about an hour and a half. And so we need a lot of volunteers to help to accomplish that. And so if you're interested at all, please give us a call or come, and especially come to a volunteer meeting so that you can get registered and assigned a position before that morning.
And please do. And maybe you can't volunteer, but you can donate. And I want to remind you, we have phone operators over here. The number is 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. And it's the donations of caring people like you that make it possible for us to be able to help so many, many people. And many of the people we help are veterans.
Yes.
Women and children, people literally have nowhere else to go. They come to the middle of the night. That's why we're fighting so hard to keep the shelters open. And we need everybody out there because James and others out there, veterans out there, so many, where would they go if it hadn't been for New Life?
Right. And I often talk to people and ask them, what would you have done if New Life wasn't available? And they always, they don't know. They wouldn't have had anywhere to go. They'd be on the street.
And we want to see that no one has to sleep outside. We don't want them pushed from place to place. We want to help our veterans. We want to help those in need. And I'm asking you to join us. And please go to those phones. Please call. Please pledge your very special gift. It's urgently needed at this time.
My name is James Murphy. I'm a veteran. And I'm really thankful for the place that was here because I was homeless. And I got food and something to eat, and then I had rest at night. And I'm going to donate money, $1 a day, once I get in my apartment, because this place is needed. It'd be terrible if this place was closed down, and the people would be sleeping on the streets, and it would just be chaos in the street. I don't think city officials want that. But I'm thankful to have this place, and the VA supports this place. You never heard a word from the veterans about it. They drop people off here at the, from the VA. So, like I said, that I hope that the city officials decide that this place is needed, and that it's run, Larry's been running it for over for 30, 40 years, or and I think it's a good place to be. And people at this time, it's needed terribly to donate money to help pay the bills for this house, for the electric and gas. And like I said, I'm going to donate. And I, just like some other veterans, once they get settled and get their income going on, that they can make $1 a day isn't that much to support Larry in this place, to keep it open and to pay the bills. And I'm very thankful, and I praise God I've become closer to Jesus. As I said, my name's James Murphy, and I'm a Vietnam veteran. Larry is here and helping.
Thank you, and thank you for joining us at this time, Kathy. When people give, they're literally giving to the Lord, aren't they?
Yes. Yes, they are.
And we wanted to say thank you to the people for giving to the Lord. I mean, you work in the kitchen. You yes. came here homeless. You never thought you'd be homeless?
No. No, never sir. Thought. And had no idea what it was like.
Was it frightening?
Yes. I was scared to death.
Now, if the place had not been here, how would your life be different?
I probably would not be living right now.
Wow. So people need to understand we have to fight to keep New Life Evangelistic Center open, don't
yes,
we?
Yes, yes. Just not for adults, but for the children.
And for the veterans.
Yes.
And we want you to give as unto the Lord. The devil loved to shut this place down, love to cut off the financing, love to stop us to just not helping the people in need or shut the doors, but we're not going to do it. We're trying to stand firm, but we need you. We need them. We need people to share food right now. We urgently need some food, don't we?
Yes, especially meat, but we are thankful what we do have. And
yes.
We feed the homeless, and it's a good work for me to know I Amen. Feed somebody else.
It sure is. And as she indicated, we need people to donate chickens. And somebody donated a cow recently. They had it all cut up and butchered and brought in. We praise God for that. But meat, fish, deer. People go out deer hunting, you know, please. Each thing you give is a gift to God. And every dollar you give is a gift and an opportunity for individuals like Kathy to have an opportunity to serve God, right?
Yes, yes. And it's a pleasure because God has always been here for me. And it's my turn to help others.
Amen. And I want to say thank you for giving unto the Lord. Each and every one of you that are doing that, you're having such an impact on the lives of so many people at this time, all over Mid-America, whether it's St. Louis or whether it's Springfield or Joplin or Marshfield or all over Mid-America. You are touching lives. And I want to say thank you for giving unto the Lord. And I want to encourage you to come over the phones. And right now the number is 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. We praise God for those that are giving. We have Eugene Brown, praise God, sharing a gift of $200.
Yes,
isn't that exciting?
Yes.
From Jerseyville, Illinois. And we have Lance Harris using a Visa card, and they can use their Visa card, MasterCard, whatever, sharing a gift of $50. And we just thank God for Martin Hawkins sharing a gift of $20 using the MasterCard. So everybody that's given, we just want to say thank you for giving to the Lord, don't we?
Yes, thank you so much.
And I know you're out there working with the women and children. I'll let you go. God bless you, and thank you for dropping in.
God bless you.
Thank you. That's Kathy, and I want to, she's sharing her life now in serving Jesus, and I want to encourage you to share from what God has given you as we say just thank you for giving unto the Lord.
Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave. Then another man stood before you and said, remember the time a missionary came to your church. His pictures made you cry. He didn't have much money, but you gave it anyway. Jesus took the gift you gave, and that's why I'm here today. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave. One by one they came, far as the eye could see. Each one somehow touched by your generosity. Little things that you've done, sacrifices made. Noticed on earth and heaven now proclaimed. And I know up in heaven you're not supposed to cry, but I am almost sure there were tears in your eyes as Jesus took your hand and you stood before the Lord. He said, my child, look around you, for great is your reward. Thank you for giving to the Lord. For I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave. Thank you for giving to the Lord. that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave. I am so glad you gave.
A reminder to you, yes, a lot of us have changed it throughout the years, but we say thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness. There's been a lot of people that have come through the doors of the New Life Evangelistic Centers, whether it's in Joplin or St. Louis or a host of other places. Thousands and thousands and thousands of people. And this is no time for us to quit, brothers and sisters. It's no time for us to give up. It's time for us to give it to God. For we are truly more than conquerors through Christ who strengthens us. And I want to encourage you to stand with us at this critical hour, to go to the phones and call. The number's 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. So many people have another chance. So many people have another opportunity because of those of you that are sharing with the New Life Evangelistic Center at this time, those of you that are giving at this very critical moment. I just want to say thank you for making it possible for so many people that otherwise would just be alone, dying on the streets, turned away by the hotlines, turned away by other places, now having a second chance. He's a God of the second chance. And you're giving people a second chance by calling. You're reaching out to prodigal sons and daughters all over. You're helping us to stand steadfast, immovable, abounding in the work of God in spite of what some might say and some might try to do. We're not going to just go away. We're going to stand steadfast. We're in a battle against principalities and powers, but greater is who's in us than he that's in the world. Please, this is no time to retreat. This is a time to move forth. This is a time to remain faithful. This is a time to stand steadfast. So don't retreat. Get up and go to the phones and call right now and pledge your very special gift and know that as a result of your giving, lives are being changed.
My name is Daniel Schmidt and I'm in the New Life Evangelistics Center, and I just got assigned for the two-year program, which is going to totally inspire my spirituality and to help me as a homeless man. Reverend Rice has been gracious enough to allow me into the two-year program. And I'm looking forward to going to Columbia Thursday to be of service for the fellowship. And I hope that it inspires me to gain knowledge in my life and closer to Christ. Reverend Rice's shelter has provided me a safe place to stay and some food. They've provided me with clothing. And it's a great organization, and I'm looking forward to serving as a fellow membership in NLEC. I'm not sure exactly what's going to transpire out of this, but I'm hoping that my spirituality grows, for one. My ambitions and aspirations to further my spirituality is my main goal. And joining the fellowship.
Yes, New Life Evangelistic Center is a holistic program that shares that there is hope, Christ is risen. Yes, in word and deed, helping people to grow in their faith and discover their God-given talents, moving out among the hurting and homeless, discovering that every person has a talent, giving people a second chance. That's why the devil's so mad. That's why those principalities and powers are coming at New Life Evangelistic Center so hard. They'd like to shut down the last major walk-in shelter, but we're not going to let it happen. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. It'd be a travesty to stop what God is doing at this moment. Lives are being transformed. Stand with us, brothers and sisters. Don't quit now. The number is 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. Stand up, move forward. Greater is he who's in us than he that's in the world. Be with us now as we continue to reach out and share that there is that hope that only Christ can give. And as we continue to fight the good fight, join us. Will you do that? And go to those phones right now.
My name is David Johnson, and I just wanted to say to the community that Reverend Rice has been a vital part of the community, providing basic needs, food, clothing, shelter to families and children and women and men, and that this community, it would be a travesty for this community to lose him. They're, you know, the homeless people would probably more than likely become more incorrigible than what people might think that we are now. And, you know, it's just wonderful to know that God has somebody here in the community that cares for the homeless, the sick, and the poor. You know, it's so often that people are into making money, you know, and that's all they want to do, and they don't care about the people who are homeless and the people who need shelter, clothes, and food, you know. But, you know, Jesus said in the Bible that when they came to him and said, "Lord, Lord," he said, "I don't know you, because, you know, you didn't visit me in prison. You didn't feed me when I needed some food. You didn't give me shelter when I needed shelter." And they said, "Lord, when did we not give you shelter? When did we not give you food? When did we not give you clothing?" He said, "When you did this to the least of my servants, that's when you did it to me." So we just want you guys to help support Reverend Rice, and he's doing a good job here in the community. He always has. I've been following this man myself for over 20 some odd years. I came through here in 1989, around Christmas time, and, you know, I was able to have a joyous Christmas just because of Reverend Rice. So we just want the community to come on out and support. You know, there are hearings currently now to try to stop Reverend Rice from doing this great work of God, this labor of love for the community. And we need people to know that, you know, without this type of compassion for the members of the community, the downtrodden, the sick, and the homeless, that, you know, that it would be even worse in the downtown area. That, you know, that not all the time do a few bad apples spoil the whole bunch. So I just want to thank God for Reverend Rice and the works that he's doing here. And I just hope that you will come on out and support us, bring donations for you know, people who really are less fortunate and that would not have anything if it were not for you.
Karen, we just heard from this gentleman how important people's donations are here. You see the women, the children, the babies, the veterans, all those that we're helping out there. It's important that people get involved right now, right?
Most definitely. Most definitely. We have a great need here at New Life Evangelist Center. We have so many people who come into New Life every day. Every day, more and more people come in to New Life homeless. And it just broke my heart with the man that's 81 years old, that was a veteran on the street for 7 years.
Korean War veteran on the street for years, right?
Right, right. And New Life Evangelist Center hadn't been here for him, he would be still on the street, 81 years old. And it's just...
Yes, and we've seen many like that throughout the years. And we need you to stand steadfast at this moment. I mean, we've had to spend over $120,000 since September 24th of 2013 just to continue to fight the principalities and powers that would try to stop us from sheltering that 81-year-old veteran and you and your children and other mothers and their children. Right. I mean, we need the body of Christ to rise at this moment, don't we?
Yes. There are a lot of people out there who claim that they're children. I want to... question anybody's Christianity, but this is your time to stand up and speak out and just help everyone.
You know, and exercise that faith. Not just be a hearer of the word, but be a doer also. Right. And get involved at this critical moment in the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. These are perilous times. Right. The financial needs are really great. We need to believe God for a financial miracle at this moment. We still owe the attorneys about $16,000. Just believe God with us. And yet that's a bargain, the $120,000 we've had to pay, because if we just gave up the fight, it cost us $180,000 a month just to put the people in hotels, you know, all the people that came. If at $30 a night, $200 a night, and then that doesn't include the over 50 people that are in training programs like you and others, okay?
Right.
That they don't realize they'd all be out on the street. So we must continue to remain steadfast at this hour, and we need you to go to the phones and call. You're at the phones, is that correct?
Yes, I am.
And you welcome a call right now, wouldn't you?
Right, I'm waiting for you to call.
All right, well, let you come back over here to the phones, okay? Folks, please, in this remaining minute, do call, do pledge, do care, do share. Let the light and love of Jesus shine in you and through you at this particular moment. And get up and go to these phones and call. And let your light so shine before men and women, they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. New Life Evangelistic Center's indicated receives no city, state, or federal dollars. The great control the city of St. Louis has over the federal money coming in. And we see all these city-operated shelters that have become totally quiet when it comes out about speaking against injustice and how they're afraid to speak up. Well, we maintain this independence. We also receive no United Way funding. So if you really want to help the people that you see here on these programs and here, then you need to just get involved. And all over Mid-America, people are being helped. It's 1-800-334-3276, 436-2424. You can give online with your credit card at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. Or just write out that very special, much-needed gift now and send it to New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. Thank you for caring and sharing at this very critical moment.